Warning: this experiment handles fires and self-igniting mixtures. Fire safety protocols must be in place. Greetings, fellow nerds. Let's do some classic chemistry. You're all familiar with matches, those convenient means to produce fire, invented over a century ago and still remain in use today. The modern safety match works by reacting a red phosphorus striking surface with a match head consisting of potassium chlorate, sulfur, starch, silica, and a few additives like zinc oxide. Phosphorus has been a key component of matches, but the match head can be ignited by other chemicals. I showed in a previous video that matches could be lit using sulfuric acid, avoiding the use of phosphorus. While it's not exactly convenient or safe to carry around a bottle of sulfuric acid to use with your matches, before the advent of phosphorus-based matches, sulfuric acid-based matches were indeed employed. They were called the Promethean Match. They worked by having a capsule of sulfuric acid coated in potassium chlorate and fuel mixture in a paper tube. You just crush the capsule and the sulfuric acid would react with the potassium chlorate fuel mixture and ignite it. I am going to make them in this video. First, we start with paper straws. These will be the body of our match and should be easy to get now that plastic straws are being replaced. Pinch off a few centimeters of the straw and then add a couple of drops of glue. We want to seal the bottom and create a compartment for the chemicals we'll be adding later. I'm using super glue or cyanoacrylate so they dry quickly, and I don't have to wait here for too long. Make several straws this way so we have spares. Once you're done, set them aside to dry thoroughly. Now to make the capsules of sulfuric acid. First, we get some pasture pipettes and flame seal the tips with a torch. Once we have several, it's time to fill them with acid. To each pipette, we add a couple of drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. A rough way of gauging it is to fill the filling pipette with about 2 centimeters of acid. Do not add too much acid or we won't be able to seal the capsules later. And there are our pipettes with acid in them. They have these bubbles in the bottom, so shake them down. And there we go, tiny little closed pipette tips with acid in them. To turn them into capsules, we carefully flame seal the pipettes. I know I make this seem so easy, and I'll be honest, it is, but wear gloves and a face shield. If you heat the capsule the wrong way near the acid, it'll explode and splatter acid on you. Maybe practice a few times with empty pipettes first. And there we are, tiny little sealed capsules of sulfuric acid. Give them a shake to coat the inside with acid as we'll need to test for leaks. I have here a vial with a solution of sodium carbonate in water and we drop in our sulfuric acid capsules. Watch them carefully and check for any bubbling. If the sulfuric acid is leaking, then it'll react with sodium carbonate solution and fizz. That will tell us to discard that capsule. We don't want premature activation of our matches. Looks like all my capsules are good, so we can make the chlorate mixture. I have here 21 grams of potassium chlorate, and to this I add 7 grams of sugar and thoroughly mix them. The sugar will be our fuel, but other flammable substances may be used like starch. To test the mixture, we pour out a small quantity and add to it a few drops of sulfuric acid. It should ignite and catch fire. This proves its efficacy and we can start loading our matches. We take our closed straws from earlier and insert one capsule of sulfuric acid. The capsules should be shorter than the length of the compartment. Then we pack in the potassium chlorate and fuel mixture. Don't fill it completely, but leave half a centimeter so we can seal it. Once we have a few straws loaded, we seal the tops and glue them shut. Be very careful because if the capsule breaks when you squeeze the straw, it'll ignite. That's why I said the capsules should be shorter than the compartments. Wear a face shield and protective clothing when doing this. Anyway, once that's done, let them dry. And finally, after all that work, we have our Promethean matches. To use them, we have to break the sulfuric acid capsule inside and mix it with the potassium chlorate fuel mixture. You could do it with your fingers, and Charles Darwin bragged about using his teeth, but for safety, it's best to use a pair of pliers. We just squeeze the match head until the capsule breaks. Whoa, and that was a pretty good one. Dipping these in wax might make them more flammable. But as fun as this is, modern matches are still orders of magnitude safer and better. These can go off if you drop them or break them. I also found they weren't perfectly reliable and sometimes they didn't work. Or worse, they exploded. So be sure to have detailed fire safety protocols and physical protection if you're attempting this experiment. Nonetheless, these are a very interesting historical attempt at taming fire. While they were probably pretty expensive from all the labor needed to make these, especially the sulfuric acid capsules, the dramatic flair in using them must have been impressive. I can certainly see rich individuals using them to show off while the uncultured masses used more common flint and steel. So that was the Promethean Match, a classic chemistry device almost forgotten to time, and the ancestor of the modern phosphorus-based match. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.